since when did every party on campus all of a sudden have to have some stupid theme attached to it?
I know! And you know what? This is the last time I'm getting dressed up with you. It's getting kind of weird.
Blaine, do you have the key?
I thought you had it.
That's weird, I swear.
Whatever, I'm just gonna crash on the couch.
Oh, hey guys, what's going on? Hey, I hope you don't mind me staying here. I needed a place to crash, so I kind of let myself in.
What the hell? I changed the lock.
No! No, you're gone! He's gone! Why is he here? Why are you here?
Yeah, last I heard you were in New York.
Yeah, well, I left.
You left New York?
Would you forget something?
Did you want to cast me in something? Because I think I'd make a great Rockette.
No, that's not happening.
Why are you here?
Well, Blaine, it's a long story. Filled with love, lust, talent, sex, and most importantly...
Oh my god, you screwed something up, didn't you?
Well, yeah, but that's besides the point. Listen, man, I had everything. I had the hit play, I had the leading lady, I had the life. And then I was betrayed, man, and it just fell apart.
You were betrayed by who?
Oh, just the lovely Maggie herself.
Maggie? You had our Maggie?
My Maggie? Yes. She was unbelievable.
Oh my god, I swear there's gotta be someone out there for me.
Hey man, I'm sure there is.
Probably not.
But listen, I cast Maggie in this play that I was writing about these college kids who live in a college dorm. It's clearly not a dorm because I just slapped up a bunch of posters I found it.
You didn't have a set designer, did you?
No. Nor did we have any kind of budget. But listen, the point is, I cast Maggie, and she was magnificent, man. Like, she was a star before she even knew it. And, before too long, we ended up falling in love. And you know all those things you wanted to do to her body?
Oh.
I tried them, man, and they worked.
What?
And I got all the credit for it, too.
What?
And then the show became a hit. I started getting money. I started getting fans and good reviews. I had people kissing my ass. And I just lost control. I wasn't exactly faithful to just Maggie, which apparently girls don't like.
We really don't.
What?
Look, why are you here?
Well, I was so depressed about the whole Maggie fiasco, I ended up getting sloshed and signing all the rights to Mel Brooks. Get this, the parts of Blaine and Travis are being played by Nathan Lane and Matthew Broderick. Those bastards.
Nathan Lane? Look, did you say Blaine and Travis? Should we be getting some kind of royalties?
No, I already spent all that. But listen, that's besides the point. Back now, we can get back to those wacky adventures we used to have, remember? Remember all those girls? Well, never really had very many girls. We certainly had some good times, though, right? Like, not, you know, great times or anything, but times.
Look, we get it. This is too much. I'm gonna go use these legs and hit the parties again.
Look, here's the deal. I guess if you need to, you can stay on our couch for a little while, okay?
Look.
Key word, being a while.
Hey, man, don't worry. I'll be here a long while. It's no problem.
No. A while.
All right, man. I think I know what you're trying to say. But listen, I really appreciate this, you okay? Thanks a lot, man. And if you want, there's a little bit of room on this couch for the two of us, buddy.
Not that kind of girl.
You sure, dude? This couch gets kind of lonely without Maggie. Maggie!
What the hell are you doing?
Nothing. That's kind of awkward.
What is?
Oh, this couch is awkward, dude. I haven't quite cracked the code on how I want to sleep on it yet.
That's funny. You're a jokester. Go to bed.
Sweet dreams, dude.
My life seriously needs to get better. Although, I could do worse than Nathan Lane.
The show is brought to you in part by the Michigan Militia.
What? You're pregnant?
Caught, that's a wrap.
All right, hey, good job today, guys. Everyone. Good work.
Good job, good work. Hey, good job out there, man.
Thanks, man. Listen, we have a lot of fun here at the show, but there's one thing we don't joke around about. The Michigan Militia. Hi, I'm Nick Pelton.
And I'm Mike Mottola.
We're here to talk to you about something that's very close to our hearts, the Michigan Militia.
That's right, Mick. Founded by good old grandpappy Norman Olson in 1894, the Michigan Militia is the second largest armed group in the United States, right behind the Army.
The Army!
The Michigan Militia is open to American citizens, regardless of race, creed, color, hint, hue, or hair color.
But preferably white.
And we're open to anyone of any religion.
But preferably fundamentalist Protestant.
And anyone of any political affiliation whatsoever.
And you guessed it, preferably uber-conservative.
Did you know that during World War II, when Mr. Roosevelt needed more ammunition to kill the Kaiser, he turned to the Michigan Militia for their massive stockpiles of weapons buried deep below Lake Superior?
And when Lord Zeno of the Tribulon 5 returned from space to harvest his crops of humans after thousands of years of lying dormant, it was the Michigan Militia that imprisoned him back into the volcano of lost souls for all eternity.
And were you aware that the Great Lakes were originally in Nebraska? Nuts to that!
That's right, Nick. The Michigan Militia has always been there for us. But have you been there for the Michigan Militia?
If you join now, you'll get a special edition Michigan Militia mug, a Shoot the Messenger t-shirt, and also, if you call within the next 5 minutes, we'll give you a very special Babes in the Militia calendar.
Is there anything better than scantily clad women holding semi-automatic weapons-grade rifles?
Well, only if she's reciting the Second Amendment word for word.
Well, we want to thank you for your time tonight. And remember, if Ohio, Indiana, Wisconsin, and/or Canada is ever threatening your civil liberties, and you have no one to call, call the Michigan Militia.
The Michigan Militia. You're either with us,
or you're against us.
So that was a triple shot of mocha in a what size again?
Okay, look. For the third time, that was a grande mocha latte with extra whipped cream, skim milk, and 3 extra shots of mocha.
Okay.
Got that? Okay, listen, you really have to hurry this up. I'm late for a meeting.
Look, maybe if you're a little bit more patient, you get your damn cup of coffee.
Do you need any help up here? Yeah, I can just make it for you. I'm in here all the time. Maybe not. Okay, whatever. Never mind.
Thank you.
Sure.
Jeez, what the hell was her problem?
I don't know. Sometimes customers... Blaine Hargrove?
Darcy Cooper, what are you doing here? I thought you went to school in Ohio.
Actually, NYU, but nice try. I transferred here this semester to be closer to home.
Wow, this is so amazing. I was totally just fantasizing about you. I mean, I was dreaming of you. That's not it. I can't talk. Let me start over. How are you?
God, why didn't we date in high school?
Ben Porter.
Oh, well, who really knows what he's up to now anyway?
What? You mean you guys aren't still going out?
No. Something always seems to go wrong. Ben! I don't know. Are you with anyone now?
Oh, well... You know, there was that one Australian chick, but I couldn't understand a damn word she was saying with her crikey this and crikey that, you know. Then there was Maggie, but she's going out with some loser now.
Hey, Blaine. Oh, look at this. Someone left a perfectly good enchilada in the trash can. Again. Ah.
So, yeah, I'm free.
Well, that's good, because maybe we can finally get together.
Oh, wow, yeah, that'd be great. I get it. You're joking.
Maybe. But. Well, listen, I'm having this Halloween party tonight, and you should totally stop by.
Well, yeah.
So, I'll give you my number, and you can call me, and we can talk, but you have to wear a costume. So, it'd be really funny if you dressed up as Batman, because remember when you used to be obsessed with Batman, never thought you were weird?
Good thing I got over that.
Yeah, really good. So, I should probably get back to work.
Oh, yeah, you do that, and I'll find you later.
Yeah, mind if I find you first?
Blaine, I locked myself out of the dorm again.
You know what? That's okay. Let's go.
Yeah? All right.
You hungry?
I could go for another enchilada.
David Cooper, the world needs you again.
David Cooper, you took my face. I think it's about time I take it back.
David, you're not listening. He's a rogue agent presumed dead years ago. He's stolen the beginner virus and he's going to kill you, even if he has to destroy the whole world.
I cannot wait to see that movie.
I know, it looks so good. Oh, Travis, hang out. Like, this is so much fun. We need to do this all the time. Oh, except next time I'll bring the popcorn and you can bring drinks.
Oh, that's such a good idea. That is for sure the plan next week.
All right. Oh, yeah, you didn't see last week's episode. I have to fill you in.
Hold on. Okay, ready, I'm going.
All right. Let me tell you. Okay, so Erica was with Mike last episode until she found out through Sydney that Mike was seeing someone else behind her back.
Obviously.
So, Erica finds out, and then she gets so mad, she decides she should see it for herself before she can get even.
Mike has been such a sneak the past few episodes.
I know! What's she gonna do? So, what happens is she decides to follow him from the gym, to the library, to the cafe, and do you know who he's meeting up with there?
Who?
Cindy!
No!
I know! I can't wait to see what happens next!
Hold that thought, it's on.
Holy crap, you guys would have no idea who I just saw at the cafe.
It wouldn't be someone with manners, would it?
Yeah, what the hell?
No, I met some girl named Ben Porter.
Dude, her name's Darcy.
Oh, her?
Can I tell the story?
Sorry, but can I continue?
Go for it.
I'm sorry. Thank you. It was Darcy Cooper.
Who is Darcy Cooper?
Yeah, why is she important?
Who's Darcy Cooper? Just the girl I'm going to spend the rest of my life with.
Okay, Blaine, I like love stories and all, but hello, Bondage Beach.
Hello, my life. You guys don't understand. She is like my ultimate crush growing up. I mean, we grew up next door to each other, and I haven't seen her since we both left for college.
So what's the big deal? You haven't seen this girl since you graduated from high school?
She went to NYU, and I got accepted here to Michigan State. Man, I was crushed. God, I've been in love with this girl since I was like 5 years old.
How have you been in love with this girl your whole life, and I've never heard of her?
Well, I mean,
things never even took off the ground. Dude, she's been playing them hot and cold for years.
Are you kidding me? Are you seriously kidding me?
Sorry.
Can I please finish the story? I never should have told you the story in the car before we got here. Okay, can I continue? Thank you. He's right. She's been playing me hot and cold for years. You know, I got these feelings for her, and I know she has feelings for me. But it seems like every time we get serious, she freaks out and runs off with some other guy. God, it's been like that as long as I can remember.
I wonder why.
Hi, Blaine.
Yeah?
I love you.
Really?
No.
Darcy? Darcy? Is that you?
Where are you?
I'm in the locker.
Oh my god, are you okay?
Shocker!
What's the combination?
The 15, 7, 32.
Oh my god, please!
Thanks, Darcy.
Who did this to you?
Ben Porter.
What a jerk. I told him not to pick on you anymore.
Thanks. Hey, do you want to go get lunch now?
Actually, I'm going to go sit with Ben.
Oh, hey, Darcy.
Hey, Darcy, what's up? So, I'll be picking you up at 8 tonight for the homecoming dance.
Oh, actually, I just got asked out by Ben Porter.
Ben Porter? Ben Porter?
Yeah, so I can't go with you anymore. Sorry.
Wow, dude. That is messed up.
Yeah, I do not get girls.
Really?
Yeah, really.
Wow, big mystery. Look, you guys don't understand. This is like fate. Nay, this is destiny. It's almost as if the people who are writing my life have finally gotten so sick and tired of me getting shot down by every girl I know that they chose this as the final perfect opportunity to advance the plot.
What?
What?
Whatever.
Look, all I'm saying is maybe now I can finally figure out how Darcy feels. Oh. She's having a Halloween party tonight, and I need you guys to be there.
Oh, let's go dress as Paris and Nicole.
Sadly, my Paris and Nicole days are behind me.
Dude, I'll do it, man. But I have to be Paris.
Right, well, I do look hungrier than you.
Great. So we're all going.
Well, now that I've missed my television show, I might as well go to class. Travis, I'll see you later.
See you at class?
Well, I am going to go work on my costume.
I'll be here.
Unfortunately.
Stay sexy.
Bye, babe. Do you love it?
What are you guys talking about?
I'm practicing our Paris and Nicole.
I hate you guys.
Yeah.
Now, try it poutier and leggier. Blonder also. Mm. Yeah, can you get your legs out?
Hey, Travis.
Hi, what's up?
Not much. I'm just wondering what I'm gonna have to do to get this internship this summer.
Oh, I know. I really need to get one of those spots. It's pretty much the only thing getting me up at 8 a.m. every day.
Oh, I know. I will literally do anything. I mean, this determines whether I get a job when I graduate.
This determines pretty much if I graduate.
Oh, you know, as much as I hope I get one of the spots, I hope you get one too, so that way we can work together this summer.
Oh, that would be so much fun.
Well, boys and girls, it looks like it's going to be another grueling year here in Fashion 375. And I know you're all going to be trying very hard for those internship spots this summer in Italy. However, I do have some bad news on that front. There's only one spot available.
I'm rubbering
your glue. You're the fucking spy!
with Nat, you guys. Okay, so it's a huge night for me. Please, please do not embarrass me.
Oh, come on, man. We're not gonna embarrass you. Look, how do my lips look?
It looks great.
Oh my god, I gotta get new friends.
Blaine, quit being so uptight. I mean, if she likes you like she says she does, this is probably gonna be the best night of your life.
Yeah, dude, we're gonna be drinking beer and eating candy all night long.
Dude, we're in our 20s. Probably not gonna be a lot of candy there.
What? No candy? Hey, you, kid. Yeah, you the candy. Hey, you respect your elders. You son of a...
Well, all right then, okay. Get psyched. We're going in. Going in. All right, get psyched. Get psyched. Get psyched. All right, let's go.
Hey, Blaine. Hey, ex-friend.
Hey, having a good night, Blaine? You're the best, Blaine.
Call me later, Blaine. We'll go see Batman or something.
I don't think that's gonna happen. He already has plans with me. And seeing as how we're ex-friends, I don't think he wants anything to do with you. So why don't you just get out of here?
Well, we'll have to let Blaine decide that now, won't we?
What's going on? I thought we were talking about Darcy.
Oh, don't mind her. She's just jealous of our friendship.
In your dreams!
Blaine, we'll talk later.
Okay. Have fun.
I always do.
Anyways, Travis, man, I think you're right about that whole Darcy thing. But you know, I'm just so nervous. You know, this could finally be my chance to see the girl of my dreams. All over some other guy? Damn it!
Oh, but dang, that guy's kind of cute.
Good lord. I kick it real fast. I got him, my man.
Great.
What's wrong, man? You alright? Hey, listen, have some of this candy with me. I gotta. Hey! What the hell? This is apples! That little punk!
Hey! I've got some Snickers in the back if you want them. I stole them from a little kid who came to your door earlier.
Really? And I can have some?
Yeah, knock yourself out. You certainly keep interesting company, buddy.
Yeah, he's a real good friend. You learn a lot from that guy.
Like what?
Well, I learned that you should never drink while meeting new people, ever. Because new people take their clothes off and end up in bed, steal your wallet, and then never ever leave you alone.
You are so funny. It's like you even wore a Batman costume. Oh god, you killed me,
You didn't really steal that candy from that kid, did you?
No, what am I, some kind of monster?
No.
Well, I'm going to meet a couple people, so I guess.
Okay.
For you, I'm a fanatic. I'm an addict. Your sexy antics turn me on like automatic. To get your man.
Can you even see in that thing?
Hey, the truth? No, I can't. Much better. At least I still can't believe that you're actually here.
What do you mean?
Well, I don't know. You know, after we left for college, I guess I just thought I'd never see you again. And here you are, you know? Halloween, in an amazing Halloween costume, I might add. You know, talking like old times.
Yeah, I do know what you mean. You know, I always kind of had a thing for you growing up.
Really? Yeah, I kind of thought so. I kind of had a thing for you too, but you know, then I see you in there with that guy. It's just...
Oh, well, we were just having fun.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I mean, I always thought you were nice and kind and fun, just almost perfect. Literally almost. Well, I promised a friend I'd go find him, so I'll see you later. Have fun.
Yeah. Okay, I'll see you later then. It's fine.
Thank God.
What the hell are you doing here? Why are you still in your dress?
Listen, man, you have to take this. Don't eat anything.
Not the first time I've had to swat out of my face. Are you really taping this?
Alright, quiet on set. So gross.
Thank you for taping, Andrew. Yeah, thank you.
Maybe don't look right at the camera.
Did you know you'd have to dress as your idol Nicole Richie?
Mm-hmm. Oh no, I am not in costume yet. I'm gonna go get changed.
I mean later.
Yeah, oh I was so excited.
Alright,
I'm sorry.
Try again, keep rolling, keep rolling.
I love that Travis went to the bar last night.
It's so funny.
Quiet on set. All right, guys, quiet on set. Let's go. Quiet on set.
MSU Telecaster.